Okay, very good morning to all my dear students. In the last lecture, we discussed about the input characteristics of common base configuration. In today's lecture, we'll be discussing about the output characteristics of common base configuration. That is when the base is made common with the input and output. Now let us see that how the output characteristics make a variation when the base is made common with the input and output. In case of output characteristics, we can see over here that the output characteristics is always drawn between the output current, that is IC. IC is the output current and VCB is the output voltage. VCB is what? VCB is your output voltage. It is always drawn between the output current IC and VCB, first of all. Okay. And then what is made constant over here? What is made constant over here? IE is made constant. IE is the emitter current, that is the input current that is made constant over here in case of your common base configuration output characteristics. Okay, so whatever is the readings that you are getting out of here is showing us the characteristics between the output voltage and output current, that is VCB and IC. VCB is the output voltage, that is the voltage across the collector base junction, and IC is the output current, that is the collector current. So let's start with this first. Here we are having what? Here we are having the emitter current has been made constant for certain start off period. Now, first of all, we have all discussed all the four stages of the regions that are actually occurring in case of your transistors. What are the four regions which are actually occurring in case of your transistors have been discussed very precisely in this very section. First of all, we have the cutoff region, breakdown region, active region, and your saturation region. So these are the four regions which are actually occurring in case of your what? In case of your transistors. Now, what is their action? How they are occurring? And what is the phenomena that is producing them? We'll be studying about all of these things in this very topic. So let's start with the first with the cutoff region. Cutoff region is a region when there is no flow of actual current. There is no forward bias current in case of your cutoff region because operating voltage is even less than 1 volt. And transistor never operates below 1 volt. If the voltage is below 1 volt, the transistor can't operate. So when the voltage levels are below 1 volt, then the region is known as your cutoff region. And that moment of time, what is the amount of current that is flowing through them? The current that is flowing out through them is the reverse bias current or your cutoff region or the cutoff current or your reverse saturation current, that is ICBO. ICBO means the current that is produced because of the reverse biased voltage applied at the collector base junction. When the reverse bias voltage is applied to the collector base junction, there is a flow of the reverse saturation current, and that is given by ICBO. So ICBO is the reverse saturation current over here. Then we are having the emitter current. When we are approaching this region, is approaching at emitter current is equal to 0.0 milliampere. And when the emitter current is being increased, when the emitter current is increasing, we have reached the emitter current to 1 milliampere. And we have made it constant 1 milliampere. And now what will happen? Now we'll try to increase the VCB. Emitter current has been made fixed at 1 milliampere and we'll be trying to increase the VCB still further. We are increasing the VCB, and while increasing the VCB voltage, what is the effect of increase in the VCB at IC? If we are increasing the VCB, what is the amount of current or variation in IC? That we are going to visualize in this very example. So let's see that what is the amount of current variation, IC variation, that is seen when the image of VCB is made. Normally, when VCB is increased, it hardly produces any increase in the amount of collector current, because collector current is not dependent upon the amount of reverse bias voltage. Because VCB is what? VCB is getting the collector base junction, and collector base junction is reverse biased. It is always reverse biased. And when the reverse bias voltage is increasing, it hardly produces any increase in the amount of collector current, that we all know. Okay. Now, what is actually producing this amount of current is IE. Basically, what is the amount of IE is amount of IC. So approximately IC means equal to IE. Whatever the value of IC is, this is IC. Whatever the value of IE is, this is the value of our IC. If IE is 1 milliampere, the IC will be 1 milliampere. If value of IE is 2 milliampere, the IC will be 2 milliampere. So it remains almost constant as compared to IC. So the values which are actually responsible for the increase in current is the value of current in the ammeter junction, that is IE or the ammeter current. So it is not dependent upon VC, first of all. So this is the action that is actually occurring in the active region. This is the action which is actually occurring in the active region when the ammeter based junction is forward biased and collector based junction is reverse biased. Okay, this is actually occurring in that region. Now, what is actually happening next to this when the collector based junction is increased further? It is increased so rapidly. When the collector based junction is increased abruptly, there is abrupt increase amount of collector based junction. Then what will happen? It will start increasing when the collector based junction or the VCB cross, it is increased very high. It is increased very high, then the very huge amount of voltage will be produced and it can damage your device. Okay. And if that voltage is still increasing and increasing, it will reach in the saturation region. It will reach the saturation region and this then that will increase the collector current to a very high value. When the reverse bias voltage increases to beyond a certain limit of the device, then it can increase the collector current to a very high level of values, and that can only be made to zero when IC is made, when VCB is made negative. While even the VCB is made zero, even if you are making the VCB to zero to in order to reduce the value of current, it is not reduced. So we need to produce the VCB to a negative value so that we can reduce that current to zero value and we can save our device. So breakdown and saturation regions are not desirable regions for any transistor. But if sometimes that regions are operated, then what we can do is we can just try to make our system or make our voltage across the collector based junction to a negative value. If you are approaching that voltage to a negative value, then we can reach a collector current to a zero value. Okay. Then next step over here is, what is the output resistance? Output resistance in case of your common base junction, that is which is across the VCB and ratio of change in VCB upon change in your collector current, keeping what as constant? IE as constant, where IE remains constant. What is this? Because the increase in VCB, high levels of VCB was producing very low amount of current. That means output resistance is very high. Output resistance is high in case of your common base configuration because the high amount of voltage, increase in amount of VCB was producing the very small amount of increase in the amount of current. So the output or the output resistance, value of output resistance is low or is high. The output resistance is high because higher resistance can only produce the low amount of current because they are inversely proportional to each other. If you are increasing the amount of current, that means resistance value is decreasing. And if the resistance is increasing, the amount of current is decreasing. This is all about the output characteristics of your common base configuration. If you find any queries, you can ask. Okay, class. Now, this is your next configuration of transistors. That is your common emitter configuration. In case of common emitter configuration, as we know, the name suggests, it is the common terminal is emitter over here. Here, the emitter terminal is made common as compared to other terminals. So it emitter terminal is made common over here. So by making the emitter terminal common, that means it is made common with the input and output. Now this is the basic circuitry of common emitter configuration. Here the emitter terminal is made common with the input section as well as with the output section. And the emitter section is what? Emitter section is forward biased and the collector base junction is reverse biased. The emitter base junction is forward biased over here. and the collector based junction is reverse biased. Forward bias means the base. It is your what? It is your NPN transistor. It is your NPN transistor. N, P and N. That means the base is made positive over here. So P is getting the positive supply of the voltage. So base is your input over here. Input is voltage given to the base current, base terminal, and the output is made negative. That is collector is termed. Collector terminal is negative terminal, that is NPN transistor is there. This is your NPN transistor. So collector is made given a potential of positive potential. That means the negative terminal is given a positive potential over here. That means it's a reverse biased voltage. It's a reverse biased voltage over here. Okay. So this is your RL is what? RL is your load resistance. It's a load resistance and it is producing the output resistance. Load resistance given the given as the output over here. The ammeter current that is made common and the common terminal is normally grounded. It is made grounded over here. The input section is forward biased and the output section is reverse biased. The input current will be over here will be your IB. IB will be your input current and input voltage will be your VBE. VBE will be your input voltage. That is VBE is made input voltage and current is drawn between the input current that is IB. So the input characteristics of this common base configuration will be drawn between the input voltage VBE and your input current IB. Okay. So before starting with this input characteristics, let us discuss a bit between the, what is your mathematical notations or mathematical equations for this common ammeter configuration. First of all, we all know that beta is a transport factor. And beta transport factor is always given by a ratio of your change in the collector current to change in the base current because it is being transported from base to collector. The transportation is occurring from base to collector, from emitter to base and then from base to collector. Now, what is the amount of recombination that is occurring in the base? That is actually depending upon the collector current. Collector current is actually dependent upon the base amount of recombinations that are occurring in the base current. If the base current is increasing, that means the collector current will obviously decrease because recombination in the base current is increasing, the collector current will decrease. So what is actually happening over here is the change in collector current delta means change, a small change in collector current to a small change in base current. The ratio of these two values is given by your transport factor beta and delta I and IB can also be written as what? IB is what? IB is equal to IE minus IC because we all know that IE is always equal to what? IB plus IC. Okay. So that means IB will be equal to IE minus IC. That means that is equal to IC upon IE. We can divide the numerator and denominator by IE. Dividing numerator and denominator by IE. IC by IE upon 1 minus IC by IE. And IC by IE is what? IC by IE is always given by alpha. It is the amplification factor. That means alpha upon 1 minus alpha over here. Then also we all know that IE is always equal to IB plus IC. And IC that has been reduced in the previous configuration, common base configuration, IC was given by alpha IE plus ICB. Now, ICBU was what in case of common base configuration? It was your reverse saturation current. ICBU was your reverse saturation current. So, over here we can write as IC into 1. That can be written as alpha IE. Can return the value of IE over here. Substitute the value of IE over here in case of IB. Alpha into IB plus IC plus ICBU. We have just substituted the value of IE over here. IB plus IC. Now open the brackets and make the transformations. We have taken the IC to the other side. IC common area. We have taken the IC as common. IC into 1 minus alpha is equal to what? It is equal to alpha IB plus ICBU. Alpha IB plus ICBU. That means IC is equal to what? IC is equal to alpha upon 1 minus alpha into IB plus ICBO upon 1 minus alpha. Okay. So this is the equation that we are getting out of it. Now alpha upon 1 minus alpha is what? alpha upon 1 minus alpha is equal to what? It is equal to beta. It is equal to beta that we have deduced over here. Alpha upon 1 minus alpha is beta. So we can substitute the value of beta over here, and ICB upon 1 minus alpha is always given by ICEO. It is always equal to ICEO. Now this is the equation for the collector current through a common emitter configuration. As this was the equation for the common base configuration, this is the equation for the common emitter configuration. That is, collector current output and IC has a value of beta into IB plus ICEO. Okay. And this is the input characteristics for your common emitter configuration. Now, what is this input characteristics? Can you see this? Input characteristics means that we are having the input voltage as VBE and input current as IB. VBE is your input voltage and IB is your input current. Okay. Now, as the amount of input voltage is increasing, the amount of IB will increase after it has achieved its operating voltage, but at the constant levels of your VCE. At constant levels of VCE, it is increasing. That is, VCE is at 2 volt and VCE is at a 6 volt. So at the constant levels of your this value of current, it is increasing. Okay, so this is the amount of input characteristics that is being drawn by the common emitter configuration. This is the amount of common emitter configuration that is being seen over here in this study. Okay, class, you can see this is your output characteristics of common emitter configuration. And in case of your output characteristics of common emitter configuration, we can see that in case of its output characteristics, it is drawn between the output voltage. The output voltage is VCE. VCE is your output voltage and output current is ICE. VCE was your output voltage and output current is IC. Now it is always drawn between the output voltage and output current. So here again, we are having the four regions. One is your cutoff region, one is your breakdown region, one is your active region, one is your saturation region. Here again, we are coming across four regions. Cutoff region, again, only the reverse saturation current flows in case of cutoff region. No forward bias current will flow inside of your cutoff region because this region operates below 1 volt of your forward bias voltage. And below 1 volt, only the reverse saturation current flows inside your configuration of transistors. Then comes your active region. Active region means when the slight amount of VCE, increase in VCE will produce the amount of current. Because here in case of this VCE, because of low output resistance, low output resistance means the small increase in VCE will produce a high amount of current. That means the output resistance is low in case of your common emitter configuration. Output resistance is low because a small increase in this value of VCE will produce a high amount of increase in IC, keeping IB as constant. So this will produce, that means the output resistance is low in case of your common emitter configuration. So here in this case, we can see that for the smaller values of increase in VCE, there is a high amount of increase in current, first of all. Second thing is, we are having the different status of this IB, which are kept in constant values after certain span of time. Okay, suppose IB is constant 0 microamperes and 20 microamperes and 40 then 60 microamperes. Okay, and keeping these values constant, we are increasing the amount of VCE. We are just increasing the amount of VCE, and this increase in VCE will produce a high amount of change in the amount of current at IC. Breakdown region means there is an abrupt increase in the amount of current and it has reached to a saturation level. And saturation level is when we are having the high levels of current inside your transistor junction. So here in this case, we can see that it is a slope over here. But in case of common base configuration, the output characteristics was exactly parallel to that of your base, emitter current. But in this case, the IB is a bit different because it is not actually dependent upon IB over here. There is a change in VCE, and that change in VCE is producing the amount of output current also. So that is why, because of this moderate characteristics of this common emitter configuration, because of its moderate input and output impedance, it is most commonly used in many applications, and mostly transistor as an amplifier. Whenever we need to act as transistor as an amplifier, we need to use the common emitter configuration for making the use of transistor as an amplifier because of its moderate input and output impedance. Because of its moderate input and output impedance characteristics, it is basically used in case of your what? In case of your transistor as an amplifier application. So this is the most commonly used configuration of all of the three: common base, common emitter, and common collector. This is the most commonly used configuration, and it is the most efficient one. It's the most efficient configuration as compared to other configurations. A change of 250 millivolt. The first question is a change of 250 millivolt in base emitter voltage. A change of 250 millivolt in base emitter voltage causes a change of 1 milliampere, causes a change of 1 milliampere in the base current. Determine the dynamic input resistance. Now, what is given to you over here is a change in the base emitter voltage. That means delta VB is given to you as how much? 250 millivolt. And change in the base current. The change in base current is given to you as 1 milliamperes. Now, units are same, millivolt and milliamperes. That means what you have to calculate is determine the dynamic input resistance. The calculation for dynamic input resistance, Rin, is equal to what? Delta VBE by delta IB. That is 250 by 1. That is equal to 250 ohms. This is your dynamic input resistance. Next question. Write your next question. Increase in the collector emitter voltage from 5 volt to 10 volt causes an increase in the collector current from 5 milliampere to 5.8 milliamperes. Change in collector current is from 5.8 to 5 milliamperes. That means it is equal to what? It is equal to 0.8 milliamperes. Now calculate the dynamic output resistance. You have to calculate the dynamic output resistance over here. And dynamic output resistance is given by what? The dynamic output resistance is given by R out is equal to what? Delta VCE by delta IC. That is equal to 5 upon 0.8. Now this is 0.8 is in what? Milliamperes. We need to convert into amperes. So it can be divided by 0.8 into 10 raised to power minus 3. It will be in amperes. Then because units of voltage are in volts, then the value of current should always be also in amperes. If the units of voltage are millivolts, then the current can be in milliamperes. Okay. So it is equal to what? It is equal to 6.25 kilo-ohms. Next numerical, right on next numerical. In an NPN transistor, NPN transistor if alpha is equal to 0.995, if alpha is equal to 0.995, IE is equal to what? 10 milliamperes. ICO is equal to what? 0.5 microamperes. Determine the value of IC, IB, beta and ICO. Determine the value of IC, IB, beta and ICO. These you have to calculate and these are given to you. These values are given to you and these you have to calculate. So first of all, we are given with IE is 10 milliamperes, ICO is 0.5 microamperes. We need to convert it into what? Milliamperes first. That means 0.5 into 0.0005 milliamperes. Okay. Then ICO is given, IE is given, alpha is given. Now we need to calculate is IC. So IC can be given as IC is equal to alpha IE plus ICO. Isn't it? Now, what is the value of alpha given to you? 0.995. And what is the value of IE? It is 10. ICO is given as 0.0005. Okay. Now, can you calculate IC over here? IC will come out to be 9.9505 milliamperes. What is the value of IB? Second is IC we have calculated now. IC will come out to be 9.95.505. Now we need to calculate IB. Now IB is given by what formula? IB is IE minus IC. We have the value of IE also and IC also with us. So can we calculate the IC, IB? IB is given by IE minus IC. IE is what? 10 minus 9.9505. So IB is what? IB is 0.0495 milliamperes or 49.5 microamperes. Then what we calculate, we have calculated beta. Beta can be given by alpha upon 1 minus alpha. Simply we can calculate by beta by alpha upon 1 minus alpha. So we have the value of alpha with us, 0.995 by 1 minus 0.995. So beta will come out to be 199. So ICO, what was the value of ICO? We have calculated the value of ICO also. ICO is equal to what? ICBO upon 1 minus alpha. Now ICBO is given to us. It is given to us as 0.0005 upon 1 minus 0.995. Now calculate this value and tell me what is the value of ICEO. Tell me what is the value of ICEO. It will come out to be 100 microamperes. So this is the numericals for your basic numericals for your common base, common emitter, and so in this way we can calculate other things also. Okay. Any doubt till now, students? Any doubt till now to anyone?